Hello there, I'm Alexander Adrian. I'm a photographer from Moses Photography. It's pretty late right now, but I thought I'd share with you this simple how-to on using Adobe Photoshop CS6's new feature, the mixer brush, to create a simple and effective airbrush effect on any portrait or photo that you take. Now, if you were using older Photoshop versions to try and get an airbrush effect, it was never simple. It was always a tedious and tiring task that usually took a lot of time. One method I used to use was dividing a picture into textures and skin tones and working on both of those layers. And yeah, so that was just a big waste of time. And this new method I've just discovered recently, fiddling around with Adobe Photoshop CS6, is pretty good and it's pretty fast. So I'm going to try and make this tutorial just as fast and hopefully not waste any of your time. Now, the new mixer brush that comes with the Adobe Photoshop CS6 works by actually sampling colors and blending them using a indicated priority color. So let's demonstrate this. Just create a new Photoshop file. All right, there we go. All right, so I'm just gonna start off by getting two blocks using a normal brush, two blocks of color, like this. Alright. There we go. Two colors contrasting down the middle right here. No blending, just two separate colors. Now, if we switch to the mixer brush tool, I've got it around 60% wet and load with an 80% mix. We're just gonna grab that brush and we're gonna pick the color we want to be predominant. So in this case, I like the very subtle skin color rather than the big red colors. Now we're just going to just brush in between it. And we're just going to create that nice kind of blend. And now we haven't got any big contrasting lines. We've got a nice blend from one color to the next. Just like that. Almost like watercolor paint. It's beautiful. And yeah, so that's what the effect does. So if you change your predominant color to the brighter color, then it will start to favor the brighter color, the brighter reds. And you can bring back a brighter red into the other side. And that's basically what the brush does. And you have to clean the brush if you want to get any colors out of it that shouldn't be there. So let's say if you're working here, but there's a black over there, you don't want to get any red on the black, etc. Yeah, so this effect is pretty decent and it looks very arty. So I can see this being used by many Photoshop artists to create a work of art, kind of like a watercolor effect. And you're probably thinking, how can I use this effect right now to create a seamless airbrush effect? I'm going to show you how. We'll cancel that. Now, this is what the outcome will look like. I'm just going to return back to the normal. Alright, so you load up your photo, and this is a pretty good photo to begin with. It's got some nice skin tones, even though it's raw and straight off the camera. If we look at the skin, there's a few blemishes, and it's not bad. But what we're going to do is create a very smooth effect, get rid of any skin textures, any blemishes, and just make the photo look, you know, very clean and airbrushed. So if we grab the spot brush tool, we'll just go over any of the blemishes, get rid of any small blemishes that you see, and I'm just going to rush through this. So if you're doing this at home with your own photos, you've got to probably take a lot more time in this. But yeah, so I'm just going to get rid of some. There we go. Alright, so what we're going to do now is we're going to duplicate this layer. And once we've duplicated the layer, we can start working on it. Alright, let's grab the mixer brush. Alright, so first thing you want to do is clean the brush and sample the brightest color in the area of color that you want to, you know, blend. So let's say this patch here is kind of similar in color. So pick one of the brighter colors from the area and grab the brush. What you're going to do is grab it, just blend it like so. I'm just rushing through this. You can take your time with this, get that perfect kind of little color, but I'm just gonna work in big patches. And then grab that. See, I'll grab that color. And because the colors are pretty close to each other, you don't have to really clean the brush until you start moving to different parts of the face. Grab the color there. Again, so you're just blending it in, making sure that there's no lines of contrast. There we go, we get this. Just pick that color there. And then I'm gonna grab it. And just blend it through. Until you get to the edge there. And grab that. So what you're doing is just creating this very smooth, no texture, kind of, it looks almost painted at the moment. And yes, that's what it's meant to look like at the moment. Don't worry if you're getting the same kind of effect. This is just the basis of what you're trying to do. So yeah, so we're just gonna smooth that out. Smooth that out there, see? All right. And if we continue to do this, you just got to make sure that when you start getting to different parts of the face, you want to try and clean the brush and make sure no colors seep through. As well as this is, you want to sample as many colors and spaces as you want and can, possibly can, so that way you don't kind of get patches. But I'm just rushing through this, showing you quickly how it's done. So we're just going to continue like that. I'm going to clean the brush at this point because I've been using a different load of colours. So yeah, there we go. Create a nice blend here. What you're going to do is keep going all across the face. Whoops, kind of went too far there. It looks pretty off. Maybe I'll select a different colour then, so I don't get an off colour like that again. There we go. There we go. Yeah, that looks better. You want to keep going until you reach a different color kind of shade. And I think that it gets really bright over here. So let's resample and clean our brush again. Clean brush. Alright. There we go. Right here as well. There we go. Get that nice smoothness going. Looks very smooth, and this is really what you want. And I'm not going to take too much time on this anymore because I don't want to keep you guys waiting. I'm sure you got photos you want to try this out on. So yeah, so now I'm going to read the unsmooth textures of the face. I could probably grab that, bring it up, try and fix up the makeup a bit. So that's not too much out there. And there we go. Now it looks very painted here, and I know what you're thinking, like, Alex, doesn't look real. Well, what we're gonna do is change the blending of it, just bring the opacity down to around 60 to 70, even 50%. And this is gonna allow some skin texture to seep through without showing too much of the uneven textures. So yeah, there's the effect right there. I'll just show you the difference between the two. This is the airbrush with the 60% overlay, opacity overlay, sorry. And this is the original. And as you can see, it looks much smoother, almost immaculate airbrushing effect. And it just, the more time you take with this, the more better it's going to look. But it really looks amazing. It only took me a few minutes to do. So this is Alexander Adrian on behalf of Moses Photography. And I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope it inspires you to use it with any of your photography and any of your portraits. And please check out our page, our website, and our blogs, and keep post comments, and keep tuned, stay in tune for more of these how-to videos. And not only am I going to show you how to use Photoshop, but I'm also going to start showing kind of tutorials on how to take photos on location at a studio using different lights and lighting setups. So just stay tuned for that, and thank you for watching my video, and hope to see you again. Bye.